Hi, everyone. Welcome to RPV City Talk on the Road. I'm Liz Brown Swanson.
And I'm Maria Soraya. We are here for the 30th annual Whale of a Day celebration right here at the Point Vicente Interpretive Center.
And we are having a whale of a time.
Whale of a time. Now, usually this event happens every year in the first week of March, but we had a little rain.
So they rescheduled it, and we're glad they picked this day because it's a beautiful day, and of course, the whales are migrating by and cooperating.
They are, and everybody in the community came out to check out the event, so we've got lots to show you. We've got some high school interns that are here helping us out, Liz.
We have the whole RPV TV team here, and of course, this event, Maria, is always co-sponsored by the city of Rancho Palos Verdes and the organization Los Serenos de Point Vicente. So I say we get the show on the road.
Let's do it. Let's get started.
Me personally, on behalf of the entire City Council, I'd like to welcome everyone to Whale of a Day, the 30th Whale of a Day. As you know, we had to delay it for about 30 days, but we have another spectacular, wonderful, gorgeous day in Rancho Palos Verdes, and it's really commensurate with what we're trying to do here with Whale of a Day. We had 11 whale sightings so far, and this is just spectacular.
What do you enjoy most about this celebration, and how important is it for our community to do this every year?
Well, you know, it really was designed as a recognition of the unique natural landscape we have in the 7.5 miles of coastline, to recognize the whales and to understand that we have a migration of Pacific gray whales going from the Bering Sea all the way down to Baja, Mexico. And, you know, we are actually part of a very important tracking program to make sure that nature is protected and we're doing the right things with the environment and the oceans to make sure that we keep just a valuable resource, not only the whales, but all the other sea life. So it is very, very important, and also it's a great excuse to have a party and get the kids all together. Many booths, many community organizations, and you know, several city vendors, and it really is kind of a hometown, almost like a small town picnic, if you will, and it's great to see the neighbors and families getting together and kids running around, so it's terrific.
It is a beautiful celebration. This entire event is put on by volunteers for the docents and also the city Rancho Palos Verdes staff. It's fantastic. We have a beautiful day today, and it's a great celebration of a great sight here. We have the whales migrating. We've had some sightings already today. And we also have the director of the Bureau of Land Management from the California Sacramento area down here to tell us that we're one of five national monuments in the California coast here.
What we're announcing today is the Discover the Coast campaign. We're really focused on three things: the conservation values, the community role in the delivery of those conservation values, and being very deliberate about engaging youth, giving them the opportunity to sense the beauty of the place and the opportunity that presents.
How come you bring your campaign to right here, this spot? How did you pick here?
There are five places on the coast, and it really has to do with the communities that said, hey, we're going to step up. We want to be part of the delivery of conservation on the California coast. We want to be a place where people meet the community and the coast at the same time. And that's why I'm here.
You know, we're here for Whale of a Day. It was postponed a month. Talk about the changes or any differences with the month postponement.
Well, on the Saturday that we were supposed to have Whale of a Day, we still had people for the census come in that day from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. and we had over 100 whales counted. So it would have been the best Whale of a Day on record had we actually had the event. Unfortunately, the weather was pretty bad, and watching was actually very difficult due to the waves.
I know that this has been one of the biggest years already. Talk about that you've seen whales.
It has been really exciting. So I've only been doing this for 7 years, but this has been my best year. It's the third best season on record, and we've been here for over 30 years.
Wow.
So it's pretty amazing.
And what makes it a good year versus not a good year?
You know, really the count. Oftentimes you'll go days without seeing any whales come through, and it's not that there aren't whales, it's just they're not choosing to come through on this passage. So there's different theories as to why we're seeing more now, and I mean, who knows for sure, but it certainly makes for exciting times.
It does. Now, what do people look for? If someone has never seen a whale, what are they supposed to look for when they come out?
The easiest thing to see is a blow from the whale. The gray whales tend to come in closer to shore when they do come through Catalina and the shore, and then you can also look for fluke prints. That will be very shiny, kind of like an oil spill look onto the water. Occasionally they will breach, or you'll see their tail and their back come up. So there's different characteristics that we look for.
When people are out in boats, is it easier to see out in a boat? Or are the whales afraid of the boats, or how does that work?
I think it just depends. Some of the whales will be very friendly. Gray whales are known in the lagoons for being very friendly with boats. They'll come right up to them. When they're migrating, I think sometimes they tend to stay away from the boats. But if the boat will just park, turn off the engine, occasionally they will come in.
What got you interested in whale watching?
I have been obsessed with whales since I was a little girl. Okay. And then once I kind of started working and got into my career, I really wanted to find a passion outside of the office. And this really allowed me to enjoy seeing whales without being on boats and also to be with all of my friends.
I'm a docent here, and I'm also a naturalist on a whale boat. So I go out and see it from the sea looking this way, and then I am here looking out to the ocean. So I have a wonderful view of the whole story.
Okay, now how long have you been doing this? What got you interested?
I've been doing this for 10 years, both the whale boat, a naturalist, and a docent. I was a college professor indoors. You don't get out very much. Walk between classes and that's about it. And I thought, when I taught math, and I thought, when I get out, I'm going to be outside, and I'm going to do something that I just love doing.
Can you tell us about the bell?
The bell. As soon as the whale watchers say, the counters say where there is a whale, and the posts are marked with numbers, one of us goes out and rings the bell real hard. So it says, come and see a whale. And that's what we did a little while ago.
Good. I think that everybody out here, the number one goal, of course, is to be at the community event, but to spot that whale for the day.
Spot the whale for a day. And they're looking far out, and I tell them, no, put your finger on the top of the fence and look just beyond your finger, or just beyond two fingers. Oh, that's real close. And I said, yes, it is real close. So that's one way to really spot fairly close. One was right over Whale Rock. I mean, it was so close that it was just amazing.
I'm Daniel Trotner. I'm the new Recreation Services Manager over here at PVIC. Very excited to be here. This is actually my first week. What a week to start. Whale of a day. It's been a great time working with staff and the docents and the volunteers. And I'm just very excited to get going and starting.
Starting off here is a whale of a way to get involved with this community. This is one of the biggest community events. What are your thoughts so far when you see how this is all playing out?
Very impressed. When I came in and saw everything that goes into just getting the event set up, the amount of staff and everyone was really putting in a lot of hard work. And it's definitely a big production. It takes a lot, but it's a lot of hardworking people. The volunteers, the docents, and staff just do a great job.
You're now going to be overseeing what we consider one of the best jewels in the community, the Point Vicente Interpretive Center. Talk a little bit about your vision.
Yeah, we have so much to offer between the rental to the museum, to the great work that the docents do. We have a great partnership with the docents and volunteers between the hikes and the trips and also just the tours of the museum. Very excited to really work with them to see how we could continue to work great and offer some programs out of the center, expand on what we're already doing. The staff here at the Interpretive Center have some great ideas. They're very hardworking and motivated, and there's just it's a beautiful location. I have the best office in the city, definitely the best view in the city. So yeah, just very excited to really take what's already been put in place and expand on it and work with the staff and the docents.
I know you moved up here with your family. You were down in San Diego working in recreation and parks. How's that all going, the transition?
It's a great transition. I went to Long Beach State, so I know the surrounding area pretty well. We're excited to be back up around this way. San Diego was great. Worked with a lot of great people and had a lot of great experiences and looking forward to kind of continuing that up here.
This is one of my favorite places to be on Whale of a Day besides out looking for whales, because I absolutely love the poster contest submissions that are hanging all around this room, because I think it really shows the sense of community that's so much a part of this event. And in the room, you know, you see people with their kids enjoying their food, enjoying this beautiful weather. A lot of them have face painting that they've had done. And it's just, to me, this is sort of quintessential Whale of a Day. It's always been such a great event, but really what I've noticed, I think, in the last few years is just the variety of outside organizations that have come and participated with us. You know, we have groups now that we never could... We never had here before, like the Bureau of Land Management. The sheriffs participate with us. We've got the Port of LA this year coming and sharing with us. So there's something new and different every year. But then there's like the standby folks that have been here from day one, like you know, the Los Serenos Docents, of course, the Land Conservancy, the Native Plant Society folks. And so it just makes for a great quilt, I guess, of all these organizations coming together, all centered around the environment and particularly the marine environment.
What's your job today, Walt?
Well, my job is to be out here in the front lobby greeting people and like I say, to be charming to the people that come in.
What do you enjoy so much about being part of the organization Los Serenos?
The people. Yeah, I'm a docent at two or three different museums. And I just love the people that I work with, and then the new people that you meet that come in. And it's just a wonderful way, especially when you get older, to get out of your small circle and meet more people.
Your group co-hosts this with the city every year. How's it going?
Well, it's looking like a great day so far, Liz. You know, we got off to a little bit of a slow start a month ago when we had that rain out, and then we had to keep our fingers crossed all through the week this week, and here we have a glorious blue sunny sky.
Take us a little back to the history and the mission of your group, what you do here.
Well, our mission is broad and yet narrow. Our mission statement says we're here to support the city, but you know, we support the city as regards this beautiful Interpretive Center Museum and the hiking trails and the open spaces around here as well. We guide tours of the museum, we explain the museum to visitors, and we take people on the hiking trails and explain the life out there.
For someone watching that wants to become a docent, what are the requirements? What do they do?
We have a class, usually starts in around the middle of September each year. It takes about 6 weeks on Wednesday evenings, and just a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful background on the natural history and cultural history of the peninsula.
Now, my son's one of the junior docents here. You also offer an educational opportunity for the youth. Talk a little bit about that program.
Yeah, our junior docent program has been a huge success. It's another one that's only 3 or 4 years old now, and we like to think wishfully that there's word of mouth spreading around the local high schools that it's a great thing to do, because in fact it really is.
You're a junior docent here, so can you tell us a little bit about what that entails?
Yeah, so being a junior docent means we lead museum tours, and it's a really great way to do community outreach. And we did a 7-week training course in January through February. I'm a senior in high school now, and I did mine 2 years ago as a sophomore. So then after we do the 7-week training course, we learn all about the Palos Verdes Peninsula, flora and fauna, marine life. We are certified to lead museum tours and do other activities in the community like this Whale of a Day. It's the kickoff event for junior docents every year.
What exactly do you do here at Whale of a Day?
So we work different stations. I worked the interactive whale site earlier, so we tell people about the gray whale, which is the Interpretive Center's sort of thing, I guess, the gray whale, because it migrates right past the coast right here. And this is actually one of the official counting stations, so the whale count that's going on outside that we help with, we don't actually help count the whales because you have to be certified for that. but that's actually what gets published as like the official number. So we tell people about that, and then we just answer questions as people walk past the booths, and it's really fun.
You are legends here at PVIC, 20 years as docents with Los Serenos. Why do you do this?
Oh, it's fun. It's just great. The whale boat is one of my specialties, and Joan, she was a manager. She was a docent manager for a while, and we just enjoy this immensely. 20 years is a long time, but it seems just like yesterday.
You've seen Whale of a Day change then, coming here 20 years.
Oh my goodness. 20 years ago, when the docents were doing most of the setups and everything, we would come Friday night. We'd be here at 6 o'clock in the morning on Saturday and wouldn't go home until after 6. Since then, things have evolved. The city is now greatly involved with the setup and everything, so it makes our life a lot easier.
Corey, this is your first Whale of a Day. So far, what's the experience been like?
It's been fantastic. It's a new experience. I mean, it's a special event. I'm very aware of special events, but this one in particular was the location, and I wasn't a whole part of the whole planning and knowing the history of this place and the event. I've just been kind of observing and helping out where I can and experiencing it just like everybody else.
You know, it's so amazing because this is the one event that everybody in the community really comes out for. I mean, we do a lot of events, but this one especially, like you said, the location, the whales, everything, everybody comes out for this.
It's fantastic. And then on top of that, the partners and the vendors and the demonstration vehicles, again, just going back to our partners. When you're looking at BLM, we had their ceremony this morning. We're looking at the Rotarians who are donating a set of binoculars. And all the vendors in between. It's great to network. It's great to see everybody out here. It's great to see the councilman and the mayor. So it's just a good, positive community event.
I ask everybody, have you ever seen a whale?
I saw mine about, I've been here about 6 months, and I kept pushing, kept waiting, kept seeing, and I finally saw one about 3 months ago. So I was excited, and we got new staff here who just started this week, and of course that's when three of them come flying by. So, but it's fantastic, and I still get just giddy, and I smile, and just think, this is where I work. It's fantastic.
It has been probably 7 years in a row that I've been at Whale of a Day, and this is probably the sunniest and most glorious weather. Even though I guess by accident that it's in the month of April.
Right. This is the first time in 30 years they had to reschedule it, but we're glad it's happening. It seems bigger than ever. And but you're wearing two hats. You're here with the city, but also with Rotary.
I am. We're real excited as part of the Palos Verdes Peninsula Club that our club has dedicated this lovely set of public binoculars for the public's free use. And as it happens, we're going to have the dedication today. And then I decided I'm going to have a little celebration at my home immediately following. And so there's a lot going on today and a lot to celebrate.
Tell us about these fabulous binoculars and how this came about with the Rotary Club.
Well, these are fabulous binoculars. They're the traditional public binoculars and telescopes you see around all the great sightseeing areas in the world. The idea for the binoculars came about as we were just talking about, as we always do at our foundation, we're looking to do things within the community. We do a lot of scholarships. We do a lot of things down at the Boys and Girls Club off the hill, but we hadn't done anything for a very long time for the public community on the hill. And this came to mind that with all the whale watching here, if somebody shows up and they don't happen to have a set of binoculars, they're out of luck. So we decided with all the space they had out on this back patio here that it would be a perfect place to add some public binoculars.
Now, have you ever been to Whale of a Day, and have you ever seen a whale?
I've seen many, many whales, and I've watched the whales, but I've never been to this event, the Whale of a Day event. I've lived here for 40 years, and I've never been to this event.
Well, now not only are you here, but you can take a look through the binoculars and watch the whales. And even though this event was postponed, it's just a gorgeous day to be out here.
It's a much better today than it was on the official day. It was pouring rain that day. So this is beautiful. Thank you.
you ever seen a whale?
Yes.
How many?
Two.
Okay, how about you?
Here today or?
Anytime.
I've actually seen a lot. I don't really know. I haven't been counting.
Okay, how about you?
I've seen a whale once or twice.
Okay, all right. So now you guys ate here. There's always yummy things to eat. What's the best thing so far?
Probably the Mexican food.
Okay.
The Mexican food. Definitely the Mexican food.
Wait, have you not had any cattle corn yet?
Oh, yeah. I love cattle corn. Everybody enjoy whale a day.
Not just talking whales here today, we're talking dragons, and that would be the LA Harbor Dragon Boat Team. Kim's going to tell us all about what you guys are about.
Okay, an LA Harbor Dragon Boat Team is a group. We have a team of adults and we have a group of children that we compete twice a year on the dragon boats, which this is the paddle for the dragon boat. We practice, the adults practice twice a week on Thursdays and Sundays. The kids practice on Sundays at 10. They won a second place medal last year in the international contest in Long Beach at Marine Stadium. It is so much fun. It gets you in shape very, very quickly. No one thinks they can do it until they come back the second, third, fourth time.
Kim, you said you started 2 years ago. What interested you in this and what do you love about it?
I had a friend, Kathy Wolfram, who told me about this for 2 years. She said, you have to come down, you have to come down. I went down once and I said, oh my gosh, I think this is addicting. So I said I'd give it a try for a month and I've been here ever since.
You must need a lot of upper body strength, I would think.
You build the upper body strength. No matter what shape you're in, your upper body builds up. It does.
Are people interested in joining? I know you have a website. You want to tell how people can find out more?
Yes, it's ladragonboatclub.org.
Where do you meet? Where do you start?
Down at the youth club in San Pedro.
There's a drum right behind me. What's the drum all about?
The drum and the dragon head are on the boats at competition day. On competition day, and we have a little very light girl who plays the drums during the competition. She actually helps you keep your stroke together.
I'm being joined by one of Taranea's dynamic duos, Marissa Edwards and Gay Van Sands. You guys having a great time?
It's a great day so far. Look at the weather. It's amazing.
You are having lots of fun with the kids.
We are. We're running fun little competitions. Everybody wants to win Captain Gray.
Tell us about Captain Gray, Marissa. I know you designed this lovely whale as you are the director of all things fun at Taranea, and this looks fun.
Well, like Captain Gray's totally fun. He's the mascot for our Tide Pool Kids Club. We wanted to pay homage to the gray whale migration that we have out here every year, and Captain Gray loves to swim at the pool and hang out at Taranea when he's not in the ocean.
This is a day to celebrate families in the community. What's happening for families at Taranea right now?
Well, we're heading into our fifth birthday celebrations, which is very exciting. So come June 12th, we will be five, so everybody can come help us celebrate. We have all the usual activities that you'd expect with some additions thrown in. We'll have the golf camps and the summer camps this summer. We'll probably be at the street fair. We're building a music festival. We have Shakespeare by the Sea coming. So all the traditional things you would expect at Taranea with a little bit more.
I think what's exciting this year is we're going to focus on some new camps geared towards that 10 to 16 year old age range. Obviously our summer camps are still up and going very well. We'd love to see people out for that and of course get them out on the golf course. One fun thing that we're going to be doing starting Memorial Day weekend, we'll be having pick and putt movie nights out at the golf course. Glow in the dark golf with movies Sunday evenings. We'd love to have everybody stop by.
Back to the celebration here. It's all about the whales and the migration, and you are very mindful at Taranea about the beautiful resources and nature. Just to go walk the trails, and you see a lot of whales passing by.
Yeah, we do, and if you come to Nelson's, we have a bell that you can ring if you see a whale or a dolphin, which is always fun. And we always have people walking the trails, seeing what they can see. Less in the summer, more in the winter for whale watching. But yeah, we're very environmentally conscious. We have three telescopes around the property, so you can look long distance. So there's always something going on, so come down and check us out.
I love it here.
What do you love about Whale of a Day?
I love where you can win a whale.
But how did you win this guy?
You have to hit it with a golf club twice, and if you get it, you have to get it in a hole, and if you get the golf ball in twice, you get a whale, and if you get it once in the hole, you get a frisbee.
We're here Whale of a Day. Of course, it was postponed, but another beautiful day to be out.
Well, Maria, you know, it's always a beautiful day when Whale of the Day happens. Every Whale of the Day that I've attended, it's been weather like this. I mean, look at the beautiful ocean behind us. It's just another gorgeous day. Wonderful to be here in Rancho Palos Verdes.
Now, I always have to ask people, have you ever seen a whale? Have you ever been whale watching?
I saw a whale at a council meeting last week. When we had a meeting here at PVIC, I saw a whale. In fact, the city manager and I saw the whale spouting. And I've seen whales out, of course, out when I was younger on working on fishing boats quite a bit. But I understand there's been 11 that came through this morning. So I'm watching like everyone else.
That's good. You know, this event, I think, especially brings out everybody in the community. Everybody runs into everybody, and it's just such a nice event for everybody.
It's just a wonderful, community gathering place, and I think everyone who comes to Whale of the Day really, really enjoys it. And I just can't think of a better place to be on Rancho Palos Verdes today.
It's so nice too, because sometimes it coincides, it's on the same day as baseball Little League, and we don't have that this year, so it's just all yours today.
Well, it's like I said, it's a wonderful place. We have a lot of good activities here. I'm gonna move around and see all the booths, especially the Raptor booth with the Birds of Prey. That's one of my favorites, and just enjoy today and enjoy the people here.
Okay, so now after being outside at Whale of a Day, we've stepped inside to one of the coolest exhibits here for the first time at Whale of a Day. The Port of Los Angeles has brought their transporter, and Sheila is going to tell us all about it. Of course, you're with the Port of Los Angeles. Thank you so much for sharing. What's going on in here?
Well, we're the Port of Los Angeles, and this is our transporter. It's our interactive mobile museum that we take out to schools and festivals free of charge to educate the public about the port and how it's important to their everyday lives. So when we bring the students in, you can notice that everything's kind of student level height. So the kids can turn and pound and punch buttons. It's very interactive and very educational at the same time. So we'll take you inside.
All right, let's take a quick tour. And how many people have probably been kids have come through here, would you say?
School kids this year, 13,000. And we're just back-to-back scheduled. And we love it. It's very busy.
Of course. You're such an important part of our world and our community here in Rancho Palos Verdes. You are our neighbor.
Right.
And share what you want the community to know about the Port of L.A. right now and the future of the port.
Okay. Well, the port is America's port. It's your port. We're the busiest container port in the nation. So about 40% of the goods that come through the port stay here, right here in our Southland area. So that's amazing. So 1 in 8 jobs are related to the Port of Los Angeles. Everything you wear, eat, sit on, sleep, comes through the Port of Los Angeles before it goes to your favorite stores such as Macy's and JCPenney's and Target.
And of course, right here off our beautiful coastline where we sit to view the whales and Whale of a Day, we also see those container ships going back and forth.
It's beautiful. And when you see that coming in, that means that the economy is booming and everything is great.
So tell about your community feedback. What are people asking when they come into this transporter?
Well, a lot of people amazingly don't know that there is a port here in Los Angeles, and it's their port, in that their tuna shoes, as I mentioned before, come to the port. Their avocados, their bananas, everything that they do in their everyday lives is related to us. So this gives them a visual perspective of the port, because not everyone can come to the port to visit us, so we bring the port to them.
Now I'm looking at one exhibit right here, and I always look up at those cranes and say, I want to get in one of those one day. But you can do it right here.
Right here. This is our simulator, probably our most popular game inside the transporter. But it gives you the opportunity to pretend to be a longshoreman, to see what it takes, the skills necessary to pick a container up off of a ship and place it on a moving chassis before it's launched off to the stores. We're just hoping that more people will see us today and invite us to come to their schools and their other events so that we can tell them all about the Port of Los Angeles.
So this is your very first time coming to Whale of a Day. Are you coming back?
We are coming back. Love it. We love the whole idea of the event.
I'm Caitlin Samko, and we're here at the Point Vicente Lighthouse to see what it's like up at the top.
Today, the Coast Guard's very proud to be participating with the city of Rancho Palos Verdes in the Whale of a Day celebration. We've done this for many, many years, and particularly because the Coast Guard has a marine environmental protection mission, which is protecting the whales and other marine mammals. We're delighted to be in this partnership.
So how often are there tours and stuff going on at the lighthouse?
We do an open house the second Saturday of every month, 12 months a year, so we'll be open again, in fact, next Saturday. But we also have an additional celebration, which is coinciding with Whale of a Day every year.
So can you talk a little bit about the lighthouse's history?
Sure. The lighthouse was built in 1926, and the property that you see today is exactly the way it was then, with the three buildings that supported the lighthouse. And the three houses were where the two lighthouse keepers, or the assistants and the lighthouse keeper himself, stayed. And until the 1970s, 24 hours a day, someone watched the light go around and turned the foghorn on and off before it was automated. Now it runs 24 hours a day all by itself, and the buildings are used for events like this, and the houses are used by Coast Guard families.
So what did you see when you went up there?
I saw like the entire ocean and everyone like waiting in line.
How many times have you been up there before?
This is my first time actually coming.
Was it scary or did you enjoy it?
I kind of enjoyed it, and it was not really that scary.
It's so fun when you talk to people that come here all the time, and they have favorite things about Whale of a Day. Of course, everybody wants to watch whales, but it's kettle corn, it's the jumpy, it's really a group of community that come together for this.
And that's the best part about it, because we have many organizations here. Some love manatees, some love whales, some love saving pinnipeds and seals and whatnot. But you know, the bottom line is everybody is here because they love the peninsula, they love the environment, and that's what makes this organization and this event in particular just a hoot.
And this is something that's very important to the city as well, to share with the community.
Yeah, we really want to share our beautiful peninsula here because it just doesn't get any better than this view up here. We're so lucky.
Well, we're invited by the city of Rancho Palos Verdes, and of course, Captain Blaine Boland wants our new command center showing off as much to the public. Since the city's Rancho Palos Verdes, Rolling Hills, Rolling Hills Estates, and Lomita paid for this, he wants to show it off as much as possible. So we're out here showing it off, and people are coming through, having a good time. Kids are running through it, but having a good time.
What kind of questions do people ask you when they come up?
What is this thing? And we try to explain to them that it's a command post. If there's a big emergency where we need to bring a command post out and deploy more people, more resources, this is where we're going to use it. And we have an area in there where they can actually plan an event, plan of attack, and then we have a logistics section back here that will have all the computers, radios, where the deputies don't have to come in here, and it's like a self-serve type operation where we'll just hand things out to them and off they go.
Now you know you're a whale of a day when you find two of our very favorite local authors, photographers. I'm here with Don Christie, Vicki Mack. They have their two books right here being sold at the Interpretive Center. We'll start ladies first. Vicki, talk about your book and what's going on here.
This is Frank Vanderlip's life. He's the man, of course, we all know that founded Palos Verdes. And today at the Interpretive Center, Frank would have loved this event. This is just what he wanted Palos Verdes to be. It was a big village.
Appreciate your very great book and your sharing, keeping the history going. Really important for us not to forget. And Don Christie won't let us forget. Of course, you are a member of the Vanderlip family, and you have up and around the bend with your stories and legends of Portuguese Bend. So share a little bit about this, what's going on.
Well, this is the very first book that Vicki and I wrote together. And I decided that Portuguese Bend was one of these areas in Palos Verdes that really nobody really knew anything about. So much history, so many stories, so many legends, so many myths, and we decided to attack each and every one of them and make a story out of it, something that's believable, something that people could really find accessible. And that's what we did with this book.
What do you like most about this celebration?
The music, the food, the people. It's a happy place. I always look forward to coming here every year.
How about for you? When you come and you see what's happening here, it really pulls the community together.
I do, and I love all the ages. We've had people coming by our booth that have lived here for 60 years, and they're still out walking the trails. And we've had little two-year-old kids taking their practically first steps coming by. So it's a great family experience. It's a wonderful day here.
Can you talk a little bit about what's going on here?
Sure. We're here to talk about the vaquita, which is the world's most endangered marine mammal. You can see it behind us. This is actually a life-size illustration. They're a member of the porpoise family, which is part of the whale group. They're actually the world's smallest cetacean. They're only about 5 feet long, but the real problem is that they're the world's most endangered marine mammal. There's only about 190 of them left right now, according to the most recent estimates. So that's a big problem. The reason why this is happening is because
they only live
in this small area right here in the Sea of Cortez, and fishermen set out gill nets like this one, and the vaquita chase fish into the gill net and get stuck and then drown in the gill net.
There are a few things that people can do to help. The biggest thing is spread the word. Just tell everybody you know about the vaquita, because it's such an obscure problem. No one's ever heard of it. Our organization has been working on this since 2012. Our group is called the Musqua Club. It's an international student organization that was started here in Palos Verdes back in 2010. We've been doing all kinds of vaquita conservation work for a couple years now. Last year we had National Save the Vaquita Day, which had 9 venues in 6 different states. This year we're working on International Save the Vaquita Day, which is going to be even bigger in Europe and Mexico and the United States and other parts of the world. So that's going to be a really major thing. So we've been doing a lot of different things with the vaquita. We've got students from both high schools on the Hill. We have about 35 chapters across the country, so lots of people are involved in this. Well, today we have one of our vaquita tables. I believe this is our 18th or 19th table that we've done to raise awareness. And basically what we do is we have a few things that people can do to learn about the vaquita. We sort of give them the spiel, tell them what's going on using our informational displays. For little kids, what they can do is they can actually pull a vaquita out of the net like this one, and then they can decorate it with the materials that we have available. We also hand out some flyers like this one. And so this flyer just has some basic information on what people can do. But the biggest thing is we're just telling people what to do. Today it's actually a little bit different because we have a special passport that young kids can use. They take this around to all the different booths at the event today, and then we have a sticker that we give them for attending our table at Save the Vaquita. So pretty exciting. We were here at Whale of the Day last year. We talked to well over 300 people, so it's been a really fantastic way to spread awareness.
So far, what's been the best part or the best thing about Whale of the Day?
Spending time with each other.
Okay.
Probably the kettle corn.
Okay, I love that.
It was really cool, like going to the booths and like seeing everything that you can learn and like do the arts and crafts and stuff.
Okay.
I'm so happy to see that we were able to bring out so many people. And right now, one of my favorite parts has nothing to do with whales, and it's going on right now. It is that band, which, I mean, everybody should be rocking out to that band.
Well, once again, Liz, it was a whale of a time out here today, that's for sure.
It was amazing. Big congratulations again to the city of RPV and the organization Los Serenos de Point Vicente for putting this all together, bringing the community together.
They do a great job.
I just have a question. Did you get your popcorn?
You know, I was just going to say, thank you for that kettle corn. It's always amazing.
And now what I want to go do with you, Maria, is make a whale hat.
All right, let's go do that. And thank you to all of you for watching. And we will see you next time on City Talk.
Again, thanks for watching RPV TV. Take care, everybody. Hey. We're on RPV TV, and your name is Lucas. Lucas is saying, I love Whale of a Day. Yay! Hi. Here is Lucas, having a whale of a time. Yeah. You look too cute in that hat, Lucas. Smile for the camera.
There she blows.
Whee! Thank you.